All right, guys, as requested, we're gonna go over a set of super useful programs that Microsoft itself has made for Windows and is maybe one of the most useful software suites ever. It's called Sysinternals, and it's been around forever, but it's not actually included in Windows. So if you didn't know about it, you're really missing out. And there are way too many programs included to go over in one video, and some of them are either obsolete or just not very useful. So I'm gonna go over what I think are the coolest and most useful programs in the Sysinternals suite. And of course, the link to get it is in the description. Let's go. Starting off, we have the Process Explorer, which is already pretty well known by itself. It's basically the task manager on steroids. It will not only show you what programs are running, but also sub-processes it's using, and a million other details that I don't even know enough about to explain. And one cool feature is the ability to search any process using a website called VirusTotal, which is actually owned by Google, and will run the file through a whole bunch of antiviruses. So if you see a certain process that looks kind of suspicious, you can scan it to be sure. And you can also search for handles, meaning that what files are being used by what programs. So if you're trying to move a file and you can't because it's in use, you can search for that and see what's using it. And here's another interesting thing. You even have the option to replace the regular task manager with the Process Explorer if you want. So there is so much more you can do with this one, but in the interest of time, you're gonna have to explore the rest of it yourself. Next, we have the Process Monitor, which, based on the name, you might think is similar to the thing we just talked about, but not really. So the Process Monitor, like the name suggests, monitors what all the running processes on your computer are doing and will output literally everything into a log, depending on what filters you set. And if you've ever wondered what your computer does, even when it's just sitting idle, then you're in for a surprise, because you will literally see hundreds of thousands of operations going on in a matter of seconds. So these might be programs calling registry keys, writing to files, reading files, making network requests. Pretty much everything going on in your computer will be listed right here. It's a ton of data, so it's probably better to filter for specific programs and operations, but if you've ever had a program behaving really strangely or crashing, Process Monitor could be a good place to start looking why. Number three, we have AutoRuns, which is a simple and powerful program that lists everything that starts up with your computer. Windows does have a feature like this built in, but it doesn't always show everything that does get loaded. And AutoRuns will not only show you what programs start up on boot, but also services, what registry keys are being called, scheduled tasks, drivers being loaded, even what media codecs get loaded. So you're not gonna see any of that in the task manager or the MSConfig window that you'd normally look at. So this is really useful, especially if you see something starting up in Windows, but you don't know how or why. You'll probably find it in here so you can figure it out. Oh, and yes, in the options, you'll again be able to have it scan everything with VirusTotal for this too. The next tool is TCP View, which is all about network activity. To put it simply, it will show you every network connection coming in and out of the computer, which program is using it, what port it's on, and more. And this can be useful in a lot of situations, like maybe there's something using up a ton of bandwidth and you don't know what it is or why. So you could start out with the built-in resource monitor in Windows, which will at least tell you what program is using the bandwidth, but you probably want to know what the heck it's connected to. So that's where this comes in. And here's another cool feature. When you find the process you're looking for, it will tell you the remote IP address, but that always doesn't really help much. If you right-click and hit Who Is, it will actually run a Who Is search and give you information about that IP address and hopefully what website or service it is. If you want, you can even close the connection yourself, but of course, just watch out in case it starts back up again. Still, there's a lot of uses for this if you know what you're doing. All right, moving on. Now we have a really quick and useful tool called ZoomIt. This one is great for presentations and simply lets you zoom in and out on the screen easily. So as you can see, all you do is press Ctrl+1 and it zooms in and you can move around the cursor. So it's great if you need to show something small. Also, if you want to draw on the screen to circle something maybe, you can press Ctrl+2 and do that, and then you can press Escape to cancel. So it's a neat little program you could definitely use in the future. Now, this next one is actually kind of funny. It's called Not My Fault, and it, well, crashes your computer. Yes, on purpose. So besides pranking your friends, you might be wondering what the heck this could possibly be used for. Well, it might be useful if maybe you want to learn about different types of crashes, and you can see that there are several to choose from on here, or maybe you want to use it as an example, or even blue screen on purpose so you can get a dump file. There are actually some uses you might get out of it. Next, we have Sig Check, which is used for checking file signatures. Now, this is a command line program, so you have to run it through the command prompt. A quick way to do that is click in the address bar in Explorer and just type CMD, and that will open the command prompt in that directory. Then you just type in the program name to run it. You'll see a lot of options, but a simple way to use it is just scanning a directory and just executable files in it. So let's do that to the system32 folder. We type in sigcheck-e-c and then system32 path. And the -e is the option to just look for executables, like DLLs included. And the -c is just so it formats the output that we can use easier. And also, let's output the results to a file by adding a bracket and then the name of the file, like results.csv. And then we can run that, and it might take a while, and it doesn't look like it's doing anything, so be patient. And afterwards, you can open up the file with Excel, and there you have it. A list of all the files it scanned, which is a lot, and which are signed and unsigned, who signed it, and some other info. Pretty neat. Now onto a tool called sdelete, which can securely delete files or directories so that they can never be recovered by overwriting it several times. I won't ask who you're hiding from, but maybe you need to do that. So this is another command line program, and here's an example for how to use it. So you do sdelete-p, which is the number of passes, so maybe 5, and then the file or directory. And I'll make a file called erasethis.txt as an example, and since it's in the same directory as the program, I can just put that. So I press enter, and poof, it's gone, never to be heard from again. sdelete also has some other functions, such as cleaning free space, like already deleted files, or similarly, you can write zeros to all the free space in a directory, but I won't get into that right now. Moving on, we have pend moves. Very, very simple. All it does is show you what files in the operating system are waiting to move until you reboot the computer. Like you may know, sometimes when a file is in use, the OS can't move it, so it waits until restart to free it up. And this is also why some programs ask you to restart the computer when you install them. And this might also show if any files are pending deletion as well. The next one is on the other side of that coin, a tool called Move File, and this one lets you schedule files to be moved after a reboot. If for some reason a file is being stubborn, you can just use the command Move File, and then the file to be moved, and the destination, and that's it. And once you reboot, it will move. And you can also put no destination with just two quotation marks, and that will delete the file on reboot. All right, next up we have Disk View, which is not a command line program, thankfully. And this one is more cool than useful, but what it does is scans the structure of your entire drive and then visually displays it. You can see any fragmentations the drive may have, and even where different parts of a file are located if they are fragmented. In modern versions of Windows, disk defragmentation is done automatically, and you don't want to do it at all on SSDs, so this tool is kind of obsolete, but I think it's still neat to kind of see how the drive stores data. It's a good learning tool, I guess. Okay, just a couple more now. The next tool is called pskill, another super simple command line program. As the name suggests, it just kills processes. You just type pskill and the name of the process or the process ID, hit enter, and bam, it's gone. If you use the -t parameter, you can also kill the entire process tree, which also kills any processes directly or indirectly created by the main one. And it even has some network options, so if you want to kill a process on a local computer, you can just type the name of the computer you want to work on. So this one might be good if a program seems to be really stubborn and for some reason won't end even with the task manager, you can do this. I should also point out that Sysinternals comes with several other PS programs known as PS tools collectively. And each one usually does a very small but useful task. It's at least worth looking at a list of what they all do. And finally, we have core info, which is another command line tool that will give you all sorts of information about your CPU, to put it simply. Just running the program with no options will give you a list of every feature the CPU supports, such as virtualization. So if you ever see something that says, only works with CPUs that support whatever, this can tell you that really quickly. And you can also delve even deeper if you want and get info specific to the CPU cache, all the cores, virtualization features, all sorts of stuff. Probably not much the average person would even know what to do with, but maybe it's at least interesting to see. So that's it. Those are a bunch of the coolest tools from the Sysinternals suite that you probably didn't even know existed. But now of course you do, and you can use it to impress all your friends with your computer skills. If you want to keep watching, here are some other videos I think you'll like. You can just check them out and click on those. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And also be sure to follow me on Twitter and Instagram for more cool stuff. It's just at TheoJoe on both of them. So I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.